It's such a beautiful day. Oh, and it's payday too. Let me log into my net banking and see. What was my net banking password? I think it was same as my Netflix password. Oh, no, I think it was my Gmail password. Or was it my office password? Nah, how does it matter? I reuse my same passwords everywhere. What? What's this? Oh no, what am I going to do now?
Hello everyone and welcome to my channel, Vinny's Vlog. You must have already got an idea about today's vlog topic. Yes, I'm going to talk about password managers and how poor password management hygiene can cost you millions of dollars, not only personally, but also for the organization or the business that you're working for. It's 2021 and a lot of people are not aware or are not using password managers. And the reasons are, you know, either there's a lack of information, the cost attached to it, or even the myths around using a password manager. Okay, so to start with, let me give you what a password manager is.
Since the dawn of the internet, reused and weak passwords, which are manually saved on sticky notes or notepads, are a bad idea. And we tend to use the same passwords on every website or app that we use, be it Gmail, Netflix, or even for that matter, net banking accounts. The obvious issue is if a hacker figures out one of your passwords, they have got a good chance of getting into your social media accounts and banking sites, not only of your business, if you have one, but it can jeopardize the organization's data and privacy you are working with. And here is when a password manager comes into play. A password manager has multiple vaults. Example, a separate vault for social media accounts, a separate vault for your shopping accounts, or for banking.
Most password managers will ask you to use a master password, which actually acts as a virtual key for accessing all your vaults. If the master password is strong and secured, you can be sure that the rest of your passwords are safe enough. Having said that, two-factor authentication or multi-factor authentication is also offered as a secondary key or a measure. So, you know, having a master password isn't enough for breaking. Using biometric authentication such as fingerprint or a face scan is also a good idea that nowadays comes in each and every phone.
When you start using a password manager, you can store all your login details in one place and even have a password manager to create a strong, unique password that even you don't know, because frankly, you don't need to know. You can set your password manager automatically to fill all the login details on any website, and on your phone, you can authenticate it with a fingerprint scan or a face scan. So you don't even have to type in your master password.
So that's how easy it is to use a password manager. Guys, I'm not here to promote any specific organization or any brand. I'm just here to have a conversation with you, you know, on how you can lift your cybersecurity posture at your personal level and also at business level. There are many password managers in the market like LastPass, 1Password, KeePass, Dashlane, Keeper, and even Google Passwords for that matter. The one problem is that some people might face, you know, when looking into password managers is that most of them are, you know, paid subscription services, but there are some limited versions available too on free subscriptions. I think the added security and convenience of a password manager are very well worth the money. And if you can't afford it, that's completely fine. Web browsers like Chrome have built-in password managers, but they are less robust as compared to the paid subscriptions. But it's a good start rather than using weak or reused passwords on all the websites. And the Chrome security password management software is totally free. Now that I have explained to you what's a password manager and how safe it is to use one, it's time to think about your data security. Moreover, if you are employed with a company or run your own business, it's time to take cybersecurity seriously, as human behavior is the leading cause of cyber breaches since decades. Feel free to follow me on LinkedIn, where I talk about cybersecurity very often, almost every day. And if you are a CISO or a CIO, you know, watching this video and plan to uplift your cybersecurity posture, feel free to get in touch with me or just flick me a message on LinkedIn and I'll be there to help you. So guys, yeah, that's the video for today. And if you have any questions, if you have any, if you want any technical clarifications, feel free to reach out. I'm here to discuss and, you know, we can explore this area of cybersecurity, which is vast. And today I've just covered a small part, but a very basic fundamental part. It's good to share this video with your family and friends and also educate them about cybersecurity and how easy it is to use a password manager. So yeah, that's my vlog for this week on password management softwares, a very small part of cybersecurity world. And yes, I mean, do share it with your friends and family, do educate them, and I'll see you in the next vlog. Till then, stay safe, stay home, and use password managers. Bye.